So these three Photoshop color grading tricks will take your color grading skills to the next level. So stick with me for the next 5 minutes as I show you how to do these amazing tricks. Okay, let's do this. Let me start by showing you how to get amazing skin tones in Photoshop. So before I do anything, I'll start by resetting my foreground color and my background color by left clicking on this icon like this. And then from here, I'm going to go on this circle. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select gradient map here. So I'm going to go on blend modes here. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to change it from normal to multiply here. And then I'm going to reduce the opacity here to 20% like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm going to go back to this circle. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select gradient map here. So from here, I'm going to left click on the gradient map here. The gradient editor is going to pop up. I'm going to go down here. I'm looking for the legacy gradients. I can't find them. They are not here. So if you encounter something like this, just go to window here and then select gradients here. So the gradient panel is going to pop up here. I'm going to go on these four lines. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select legacy gradients. So let me just move this guy here so that we can see what's happening. I'm going to go back in my gradient editor here. So the legacy gradients are now loaded. I'm just going to open this folder by left clicking on this icon here. And then I'm going to go down here. I'm going to open photographic toning here. I'm going to click on this icon to open it. So from here, I'm going to use this gradient, the gold 2. I'm going to left click on it like this. And then I'm just going to click OK here. So from here, I'm going to go on blend modes here. I'm going to left click on it, and then I'm going to select soft light here. And then I'm going to reduce the opacity to maybe 20%. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So with this layer selected, I'm going to hold shift on the keyboard, and then I'm going to left click on this gradient here to select both layers. And then from here, I'm just going to go down here. I'm going to click on this group icon to put these layers in a group. I'm going to name this group as color grading, like this. So from here, I'm going to add alternate or option on the keyboard, and then I'm going to left click on this icon to add a layer mask like this. And then I'm going to go to my tools here. I'm going to select the brush tool here. Since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set my foreground color here to white by clicking on this icon here. I'm going to go up here, opacity 100%, flow I'm going to take it to 100%, and then I'm just going to paint where I want this effect to be. I want this effect to just be on my model's skin. So I'm just going to paint my model's skin like this. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much, I can just go on opacity here and reduce the opacity to maybe 45%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. This is the simplest and the easiest way you can get amazing skin tones in Photoshop. So from here, you can just proceed with how you edit your photos. So let me just proceed with how I edit my photos. So from here, I'm just going to go to my actions here by clicking on this icon here, or I can just go to window and select actions here. So I'm going to go to my beauty retouching actions pack. Then I'm just going to left click on the face pop here. Like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So the face pop action has just added that 3D pop to this image. The effect is all over the place. I just want this effect to be on my model's skin. With the layer mask selected here, I'm just going to hold Ctrl or Command plus I on the keyboard to invert the layer mask. With the brush selected here, I'm going to make sure the opacity is at 100%, flow is at 100%. I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger. And then I'm just going to paint where I want this effect to be. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much, I can always reduce the opacity here to maybe 60%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So the face pop action here and these other actions here are in my beauty retouching actions pack. I'll put the link to where you can download my beauty retouching actions pack in the video description below. Let's move on to the next color grading trick. So let's say you are done retouching this photo, but you don't know what to do next, or you don't know how to color grade, or you just don't have a specific color grading style that you want to give this photo. I'm going to show you where you can start from, and then if you want, you can build from there. Okay, let's start. So I'm going to go on layer here. I'm going to left click on it, new adjustment layer, and then I'm going to select gradient map here. So this box is going to pop up. Let me just move it here so that we can see what's happening. This box, I'm not going to tick it. This, I'm going to skip it. On mode here, I'm going to change it from normal to soft light here. Opacity here, I'm going to take it to 30%, like this. And then I'm going to click OK. So this is the before, this is the after. So from here, I'm going to left click on this gradient. The gradient editor will pop up. Let me just move it here so that we can see what's happening this side. So this, I'm going to leave it the way it is. On the type, I'm going to change it from solid to noise. So roughness here, I'm going to select it and then type 20 here. On RGB here, I'm not going to change anything here. On options, I'm going to make sure district colors is checked. This one, I'm not going to tick it. And then I'm just going to click on randomize here. So Photoshop is going to give me different color grading styles. So I'll keep clicking on randomize. I'll stop only when I like a specific style. So I'll just keep on clicking on randomize here, like this. Let's say I like this one and then I skip it. I can't go back to this. There's no way where I can go back to this style. So I'll keep going until I like something. So I think I like this one. From here, I'm just going to click OK here. Let's say I don't want this effect to be on my model's skin. So I'm going to go to my tools here. Then I'm going to select the brush tool here. I'm going to go on top here. Opacity 100%, flow 100%. Since the layer mask here is white, I'm going to change my foreground color here to black by clicking on this icon like this. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. And then I'll just paint on my model's face. So if you've learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like this one, don't forget to subscribe and smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. So this is the easiest way you can color grade your photos. If you do not have a specific color grading style, you can start from here. So now let's move to our last color grading trick. So I'm going to go to this image. Let's say you want to make specific colors stand out. So with this image, I'm going to show you how to target specific colors. Let's start. So I'm going to go down on this circle. I'm going to left click on it. And then I'm going to select selective color here. So let's say I want to change this color here. So what I can do from here, I can just go on colors here and then left click on it. So this color is in the cyan and the blues. So I'll start with the cyan. I'm going to select cyan here. And then what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make a few adjustments here so that you can see what's going to happen here. So I'm going to take this down here. So let's say I want it to look like this. I can just take it to negative 100 or I can just add more of this color to this image. So if I take the magenta down here, I'm changing the color from blue to teal like this. You can remove the yellows to bring back the same color or I can add more of the yellows in the cyan like this. So you can just experiment with this technique if you want. Let me just reset this by clicking on this icon here. And then let me just color grade it nicely. I'm going to go on colors here. I'm going to change it from red to cyan. And then I'm just going to just give it a different look. I'm going to take the cyan to plus 45. And then magenta, I'm going to take it to maybe plus 16. And then the yellows, plus 14. If I want, I can open up the blacks. If I take it to negative 100, I'm removing the blacks in the cyan. If I take it to plus 100, I'm adding the blacks to the cyan. I don't want that. I want to find the balance. Let me just take it to maybe negative 5 is okay for this image. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. How cool is this? So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my Beauty Retouching Actions Pack. The link will be in the description below. And if you want to learn by far the easiest and the quickest way you can make the skin smooth in Photoshop, you should check this video here.